Hi, Brett McFall here, and I have a question for you. Do you have problems when it comes to selling your product or service? I'm talking about the actual selling, the actual transaction where you're trying to get people to get interested in what you offer, and then you're trying to get them to exchange their money in return for your product or service. And most people like struggle with selling. You usually feel that it's like, you feel like you're forcing people to do something they don't want to do. You usually feel that it's something which you are not really good at, and that sales is somehow a bit slimy, a bit sleazy, and so therefore you don't do it very well, you don't enjoy it, and you're trying to avoid it. Yet you know if your business to survive that it has to be able to generate money, which means you've got to be able to sell something. And by the way, we all sell something. Even if you're employed right now and you're getting paid a wage, well, you are selling your time to your boss. So at some point you sold yourself to your employer. We're all in the selling business, all right? So if you're going to do it, then you should be able to, you might as well do it the right way, right? At least the better way, the most effective way. And here's the biggest problem I find, okay? When people go to sell, what you're really mainly focused on is your product or service. How are you going to sell your product or your service? And that's the big issue. This is what actually stops you from selling your product or service, believe it or not. Because we've got to look at things from your prospect's point of view. If we look at things from your prospect's point of view, they don't want your product or service. What they want is a result, a solution, right? An outcome. And so when it comes to selling, there are three things you need to do. Just three things you need to do in order to get really, really high sales. Even if right now you are not an expert in selling and you don't even like selling, okay? Here's how we do it, and this is a massive shift. When I realized this, massive changes in my business. It was like a light bulb moment when I first sort of realized, oh my goodness, that's what I need to be doing instead. And so here's the deal. Your prospect doesn't particularly care about your product or your service. That's the first thing out of the way, right? And so the way we start any sales conversation is this. Three things to do. The first thing is this. We need to be able to get our prospect to realize that they need to change. Write that down. You need to be able to get your prospect to realize that they need to change. Without that willingness or that realization that they need to change the current path they're on, then your product or service becomes immaterial. No one's really interested, no one really wants it because you're not taking care of my needs first. So if someone is happy with their current path, or they're not totally unhappy, but there's somewhere in between, then again, they need to get to that point where they realize I need to change what I'm doing. Then we know we have an open mind. So your first goal is to help your prospect realize that they need to change their path, need to change what they're doing. The second thing you need to be able to do is help them understand that they need to change, but they need to change now. So first one is they realize they need to change. And the second rule is that they need to realize they need to change now. And this is the key, not later, not 6 months, not after they've talked to their partner, not after they've checked with someone, so not after they've thought about more, a bit more, it's that they need to change now. Those are the first two rules of the three, because with those, suddenly everything opens up. If you have a prospect in front of you and they realize that they need to change what they're doing and they need to change now, their next question becomes, how can you help me? All right, and that's the third level you need to get to is how can you help? And only then does your product or service become a viable solution. If you try and sell your product or service before those two first points, game over. They can resist you, it doesn't make sense, I want to think about it, no, that doesn't make sense, or that your price is too high. All this resistance, right, because you haven't addressed the first need, as in they first need to get to that point where they realize I need to change. And I need to change when? Now. Once you can help people get past those first two stops, boom, now you have a real chance of actually selling your product or service to that person, to that company, to that audience, then it becomes clear. Because now, if I need to change my path, then how can you help me? And boom, everything just flows. Those three steps literally change my results overnight. They will literally do crazy things for you as well if you just truly understand what that really means and you try and learn. Your question should now be, how can I get people to learn how to or want to change? How can I get people to want to change? And how can I get them to want to change now? That's a subject for another lesson, but those are the two things you want to find out how to do if you truly want your sales to be much better than what they are right now. I'm Brett McFall. That's my view. I'd love to hear yours. Talk soon. Hey, Brett McFall here again. Now, if you enjoyed that lesson, then you might also want to learn some more from me. And if you do, then I've got a link on this page or nearby this video at the very least, where I can show you how to fix all your marketing problems. What I do is if you've got problems in how to attract customers, how to get charged more for your product or service, then I have the systems that can help you do that, and I'll teach you in a very easy way. So click on the link and I'll show you how I can help you, and I'll see you there.